Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to learn about an interesting case named as a ADEM, Acute Disseminated Encephalomyelitis. Now, the case of the ADEM, 21-year-old female which is presented in the emergency department with the history of fever with rash since last 15 days and history of hemiparesis, weakness in the right upper limb and the lower limb since 2 days. You can see the presentation of the female in this video. There is a weakness in the right upper limb and the lower limb, so patient is unable to walk independently. On examination, there is an exaggerated knee reflex and the extensor plantar reflex. You can see in this video the extensor knee reflex. The reflex grade is plus 3. Now you can see the extensor plantar reflex, or it also known as a Babinski sign, Babinski positive, extension of the great toe with the panning of the other toes. Now, introduction about the ADEM. Majority of the time, it is associated with the antecedent infection or previous history of vaccination. In the 95% of the cases, it is associated with the previous infection, and the 5% of the cases, it is associated with the previous vaccination. If it is associated with the previous infection, then it is known as a post-infection encephalomyelitis. And if it is associated with the past history of vaccination, then it is called as a post-vaccinal encephalomyelitis. The hallmark features of ADEM is the periventricular inflammation and the demyelination of the white matter and the gray matter on MRI brain. Now, which are the infection which are associated or preceding infection which can lead to the ADEM? The most common one is the infection with the measles or the vaccination of live vaccination of the measles vaccine. The another one is the varicella, rubella, mumps, dengue, influenza, HIV or any other virus which can lead to the ADEM, acute disseminated encephalomyelitis. Now, it occurs because of cross-reactive immune response that triggers the inflammatory demyelination in the patient, because the antibody of the viral infection which can cross-reaction with the brain tissue and which produce the inflammatory demyelination. Now, what are the clinical features of the ADEM? The symptoms are the headache, meningismus, hemiparesis, as we have seen in this patient. Sometimes it can present with the quadruparesis or the coma. And the signs of the ADEM is extensor plantar response, hyperreflexia and the sensory loss, as we have seen in this patient. Now, how to diagnose a case of ADEM? The most common point to diagnose this case is from the history of the recent viral infection or the recent history of vaccination. And the investigation of the MRI brain and spine, which is suggestive of the demyelination and the periventricular inflammation. We can also go for the CSF study, which shows the lymphocytic pleocytosis. The cells in the CSF is more than 200 and the high protein with lymphocyte predominant. We can also see the oligoclonal bending in the CSF. Now, how to manage this case? For the management of this case, the high dose of corticosteroid is required, like the methylprednisolone 1 gram per day for 5 to 7 days. Then we have to switch to the oral prednisolone for 8 weeks. This treatment is runs for 1.5 months. But if patient is not responding to the steroid, then we have to go for the plasmapheresis or the IVIG, intravenous immunoglobulin. Thank you.